Hi friends, I am Chaitanya. Today I am going to discuss about reinforced concrete box convert having bent by 3 meters into 3 meters and dead load 12.8 kN per meter square and live load 50 kN per meter square. The HT 18 kN per meter square and the angle of repose 30 degrees. Grade of concrete M20 grade concrete and FE415. First of all, note down given data. Given data, clear bend grade. Three meters means height h equal to 3 meters, length l equal to 3 meters. Then dead load 12.8 kilonewton per meter square. Then live load 50 kilonewton per meter square. Density of soil. Density of soil 18 kilonewton per meter square. Then angle of repose 5. Angle of repose 5 equal to 30 degrees. And FE 415. FE M20 grade concrete, 20. Okay, this is our given data. Now, we have to calculate. First of all, step one. Permissible stresses. Permissible stresses. Here, M, rho CB, rho HT, M, this sigma CB and sigma HT, and then Q, N, J. These all values comes from IS 456 2000 by grade of concrete. Grade of concrete. Okay? Now, value of M. N and then sigma CB. 6.67 Newton per meter square. Mm square. 200 Newton per mm square. N equal to 0.25 and Q equal to 0.762 and then J equal to 0.91. These all values comes from IS 456 2000 by grade of cement. Then we will go step 2, dimensions of box convert. Here height h equal to 3.3 meters, then length l equal to 3.3 meters. Assume bearing code 80 mm. Assume bearing code equal to 80 mm thickness TW equal to 80 mm equal to 0.8 meters, and then assume slab thickness and side wall thickness. Slab and side wall thickness equal to 300 mm, 0.3 meters. This is our box culvert dimensions, and then we will go step 3. Step 3, load calculations. Load calculations, first case 1, we have to calculate UDL. Here, self weight of slab. Equal to thickness into density of concrete. 0.3 meters into density of concrete PO 25. Then dead load, live load. Here dead load 12.8 kilonewton per meter square. And then live load 50 kilonewton per meter square. Okay. Here 0.3 into 25. 7.5. 7.5 plus 12.8 plus 50. Total 70.3 kilonewton per meter square. Take approximately 70 kilonewton per meter square. This is UDL value. Okay, then case 2. Weight of vertical side walls. W equal to thickness into height into density of concrete. Thickness 0.3 into height 3.3 into density of concrete PO 25. Here W equal to 0.3 into 3.3 into 25. 24.75. Take approximately 25 kilonewton per meter square. Then case 3. Case 3. Water pressure inside the box culvert. Gamma into H. Here gamma equal to nothing but water density. Water density equal to 10 kilonewton per meter square. 10 into height 3.3 meters. Here 33 kilonewton per meter square. Then case 4. Earth pressure on side walls. Earth pressure on vertical side walls. P equal to density of soil into density of soil into height into sin, sorry, 1 minus sin 5 by 1 plus sin 5. Okay, density of concrete used in question 18 kilonewton per meter square. 18 kilonewton per meter square into height 3.3 meters into 1 minus sin. PF5 is nothing but angle of repose. Angle of repose 30 degrees by 1 plus sin 30. Okay. P is equal to 18 into 3.3 into 1 minus sin 30 by 1 plus sin 30. 19.8. Take approximately 20 kilonewton per meter square. This is earth pressure on vertical side walls. Case 5. Yeah. F A. And due to dead load and live load. Dead load equal to 12.8. Live load equal to 50. Total 62.8 kilonewton per meter square. This is W value. Formula for effect due to dead load and live load. W into 1 minus sin 5 by 1 plus sin 5. Okay, here W value 62.8 into 1 minus sin 5 is nothing but angle of repose 30 degrees by 1 plus sin 30 equal to 20.93. it approximately 20 kilonewton per meter square. Then the effect due to dead load, effect due to dead load. Dead load 12.8 into 1 minus sin 30 by 1 plus sin 30. Here value 4.26 kilonewton per meter square. Take approximately 4 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, here now 20, approximately 21 kilonewton.